Welcome to the latest Peer2Peer podcast from Rayner. Today we're discussing the Sophi Phaco machine with Dr Erik Mertens. As many of you may know from a previous Peer2Peer episode back in the bad days before I came along, Rayner acquired Sophi at the beginning of this year. Today we're going to explore this technology in more detail, look at what makes it different compared to other machines on the market today, and importantly, what this means for everyday clinical practice. Today I'm joined by my friend and colleague, Dr Erik Mertens. Erik is a medical director and eye surgeon of Medipolis. He founded his new multidisciplinary clinic in 2009 in Antwerp, Belgium. Medipolis is the only clinic in Belgium with a KIWA certificate, which means that the clinic meets the strictest safety and quality standards in the field of eye surgery. Dr. Mertens is involved in many ophthalmic organizations around the world and is a co-founder of the American European College of Ophthalmic Surgeons. Erik, welcome. It's great to see you relatively live and not just on social media.
Thank you, Ben, for your nice introduction.
My pleasure. So, Erik, we're going to be talking about Sophi, and you're a Sophi user. So can you tell me a little bit about your experience with the machine so far?
Well, I've been using the Sophi, I think, for around 4 years now. It has been a wonderful journey, I must say. In the beginning, introducing a new phaco machine is always a challenge for the young companies to introduce to the marketplace, because there are a lot of big players like J&J, Bausch & Lomb, Alcon, and so on. But what attracts me in that system is that it's very easy to operate on. I used phaco machines from Alcon, J&J, and Bausch & Lomb in the past, and the programming was not always that easy. And specifically for my staff and for my scrub nurse and so on, when I wanted to change some of the parameters, it was difficult. But with the Sophi system, it's very easy. The graphic user interface is really easy to use. And during surgery, when you say like something, I need more this or I need less that, if I want a more stable anterior chamber, she can really interact immediately with it, because it's so easy to change the parameters during surgery. So, and also the second thing was that the feedback of the customers was taken really to the R&D department, and they could change this really quickly, what you never see in those big companies, because it takes time and to develop and then to introduce into daily clinic. So it is a very nice journey. So the implementations of the new things went very smoothly.
Nice. And I think what everyone wants to know about with any phaco machine is performance. What do you think? What do you think, just sort of overall, in terms of performance of Sophi as a machine? You've used all the other machines. Just in general, if you had to give it a grading, A+, B, C, hopefully not a D.
Yes. I started 25 years ago, I think, with the Venturi system, with the Millennium from Bausch & Lomb. So I was used to very aggressive settings. I also used the peristaltic systems from Alcon and so on. And this system actually has three pumps. It has a peristaltic pump and a clean Venturi system and another and peristaltic pump to maintain the stability of the anterior chamber. The extra Venturi, of course, is optional. You can use the pure peristaltic pump system, but I have the triple pump. And what is very appealing to me is that I can use Venturi when I like to, and using the peristaltic settings where needed. For instance, when doing cataract surgery, I want to remove my lens in an aggressive way with the vacuum, so with the Venturi pump system. And when I do IA to take off the remnants of the cortex and to polish the capsule, I want more softer settings with the peristaltic pump. In the meantime, so there is an active IOP control of the anterior chamber. The aspiration and the irrigation is controlled by that third peristaltic pump, giving me a very stable chamber in all stages of the lens removal surgery.
For a simple surgeon like me, who pretty much sticks to one machine, regardless if it's a white cataract or a soft cataract, one sort of pump system, do I need to fully understand the Venturi, peristaltic, or will Sophi just work for someone simple like me as well? Like, You don't have to keep thinking about what system you're using.
Well, actually, that's a very good question. And because of those multiple pumps in one system, and where we have four surgeons in my clinic, so all of them have their own parameters, as you know, where everyone is wants to work with their settings. So it's pre-programmed, and we can work very closely with the people from Sophi to optimize your settings, and they stay with you until the settings are optimized. And on top of that, you can put in parameters for a hard cataract, a clear lens extraction, or when you have a high myope, the settings have to be different than from for smaller axial lengths. All of that is pre-programmed. So, and even during surgery, as already said, that you can fine-tune still a bit of your parameters, but it has to be very small adjustment during your surgery.
And are you using much phaco energy, Eric? You know, there's always a focus on us using less and less phaco energy, and you know, machines having higher vacuum and you know, trying to use less energy to dismantle a cataract. What do you think compared to your previous machines in terms of phaco energy entering the eye?
Yeah, well, the Sophi system actually has a sinus wave of the phaco power, meaning that they diminish the absolute amount of phaco power going into the eye. So the heating of the needle is lowered as much as possible, but maintaining their efficiency and also maintaining a stable anterior chamber during that cycle. One day after surgery, of course, when we see our patients back after the lens removal, we typically see clear corneas.
Do you trust it? You know, when someone's thinking of changing to a new machine, Do you trust this device with every case? Like, if you have a worst case scenario where, you know, a super high myope, a young patient, clear lens extraction, you know, everything is against you. Do you feel like chamber stability, you know, efficiency of this machine, you trust it?
Well, with every new machine, you have to learn it, of course. There's a learning phase, of course. That's why you're using these systems in the beginning in easy cases before you go to the more difficult ones. And when you gain confidence in normal cases, it's not difficult at all to start with those more difficult cases like your small pupils or hard cataracts or something or high myopes. I never had any doubt.
What actually made you change machines? Because, you know, every machine is the most important part of our career. It's how we make money. You know, it's a really big deal to change.
Yeah. Well, I'm always trying to use always the latest technology. Huh?
Yeah, I like that about you. Yeah, you do. You try.
and you like that too, I know. So, and when there's a new machine and they come to me and say like, Eric, do you want to try this machine? I almost always say yes, because I want to learn, because you always learn new things about your surgery and you always get something out of it. That's why our field is progressing. When nobody is trying new things, there's a standstill. And when we look back, 30 years in the past, where phaco was still in there, in the childhood. And now how we improved, it can only be done by people like Sophi inventing new stuff and bringing new things to market. For instance, what I like about Sophi is there is a wireless system, so the foot pedal is wireless. It diminishes all the cables on the ground in your OR. It has a very small footprint, and that was what was very appealing to me. It comes with a day cassette, meaning that you have to change your cassette only after 10 cases, which is now with the sustainability subject being so important in all of those conferences all over the world. So we started that 4 years ago. So we were at the forefront also at sustainability. We only changed tubings. And also the cassette has a very special foil in it, in the Venturi system. So it doesn't pollute the air of your OR with what comes out of the eye of the patient. So all of that stuff made me try the Sophi. I tried other machines as well, but I liked the last couple of years the Sophi the most.
And you mentioned sustainability, Eric, and that's probably going to be the word of the year for 2024. And Sophi, you know, driving the train. One big deal about this, and you know, talking point in every forum, is the reusable cassette that can be used, like you said, for 10 cases. For someone like me that's not used to that, obviously the question that comes to mind is that safe? Is that safe in terms of infection risk? That's all that really matters to me, is it safe to reuse a cassette with multiple patients? Can you explain to people listening why that is safe and why it's different to usual machines?
Yes, I'm using the machine for 4 years now, and I'm doing most of my cases bilateral simultaneous surgery, which is an extra level of anxiety for the team, for the surgeon, of course. So you have to be very careful. So in the beginning, that was something which crossed my mind. So is this safe enough? Will this not give a cross-infection, maybe in between eyes on patients? But Sophi explained to me very well, the people of the company explained well, that it was very safe to use because of the safety systems they introduced in the cassette. So there is no exchange of fluid when you put in the new tubings. So that's a very safe machine. And after in these 4 years using that in my all my bilateral sequential cases, I've never had one case of endophthalmitis. So after 4 years, you can say it is a very safe system.
Yeah, and you do a lot of cataracts, so that's a lot of cases. And I understand that if you didn't want to reuse the cassette, you could use one for every case if you wanted to. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
So have you noticed a decrease in the waste? You know, have you actually noticed you're producing less waste with your operating lists?
There was a study a couple of years ago done by a French clinic, and they calculated that the amount of carbon dioxide produced by one cataract surgery was 80 kilograms of carbon dioxide for one cataract surgery. And of these 80 kilograms, 60 kilograms was produced by the instruments you use, or the reusable or not reusable instruments you use. So it's incredible. And one of the major components which produces carbon dioxide in the production, in the transportation, and so on, is the cassette. When you have only one instead of 10, it produces much less waste in our facility.
I was actually going to ask that as a practical point, Eric. On an average list, I might do, you know, more than 10, maybe 12 or 15 cases. Can I push the envelope, or is it 10 and then it's done? Or you can really do as many as you want?
You can do 10 and then the cassette will give you the notification and then you can change it. But yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I suppose even if you use two cassettes on a list, it's better than 12 cassettes, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
And the other thing that strikes me, Eric, is it's a very sleek, slim design, much like myself. It's got a really small footprint. It's sort of reduced priming time. You know, it's a very nice looking interface. Does your theater team like it? You know, does the scrub team, do they like working with it?
Well, yeah, the graphic user interface is very intuitive. So it's very easy to play with. Also, the setup is easy and fast when we're doing a lot of cataracts in one day. And I'm only doing surgery in one operating theater. So time is very crucial to us. So changing in between the patients has to be slick and fast and efficient. I'm working with a 3D microscope. So the microscope screen is behind my Phaco machine. So because of that, Sophi machine is so slick and small, it's easy to have my full screen view on my microscope screen. So that helps as well. Those other bulky systems out there, they would block a part of my screen, which is not helpful.
And you know, you're living in the future with all this technology. I've heard that the foot pedal, you know, I really like a good gimmick. I'm a real marketer's dream. I've heard that you can move the pedal kind of like a hoverboard out of Back to the Future, my favorite movie. Is that true?
It has a brake on it, on the backside. But when you release the brake, it's easy to move around. So when doing bilateral simultaneous surgery, and I'm sitting most of the time temporarily, so we have to turn it 180 degrees. So we release the brake, we turn it, we move it into place, and we just re-break again. We can do it just with our foot to move it over. Yeah.
In my part of the world, down at the bottom of the world, the Alcon Centurion is sort of the workhorse of Phaco. It's the sort of standard. And you know, and lately we've seen Zeiss trying to break that monopoly with their machine. And they had a lot of focus on the pump design, you know, being a new pump design. I feel as though Sophi is focused so much on sustainability and efficiency. Do you think that that's enough to make people change machine? Like, do you think that Sophi will break into the market with those other features?
Well, it for sure is an important point in the near future. Secondly, because of the slick design and the multiple pump systems, it's very versatile to put in clinics where multiple surgeons are doing surgery. And because now Rayner acquiring Sophi, there will be new developments going on with the system as well, and for sure they will counter also that the pressure during surgery in the eye, as Alcon is promoting now, and the lower pressure phaco surgery, all of those things, because that team is so easy to approach and they can implement those changes very fast.
Eric, when you read about the Sophi Phaco machine, there's a lot of talk about clean venturi, and I didn't fully understand what that meant. Can you explain a little bit about what that actually means?
Yeah, well, the clean venturi means that in the cassette there is a special foil which prevents material or air from the aspiration of the eye going into the air of the operating theater.
Okay, so clean for the operating theater. I understand. And most importantly, Eric, is there anything that you miss from your old Phaco machine? Do you ever think of going back?
Not really, actually.
That's a good sign.
Well, it's a good sign. It seems like it's a promotional talk I'm giving here, but I'm very happy with the Sophi system. Very important to me is that my team is happy with it. Well, doing surgery for so many years, there are all the systems in the marketplace, and my preference happens to be the Sophi because my team loves to work with that system. So that's for me a break point for choosing a Phaco machine as well.
Yeah, it makes a huge difference. And so, Eric, you're happy, your team's happy. Do you think you've noticed that your patients are happy? Like, have you noticed any kind of difference in recovery? It's okay if you haven't, but you know, do you notice any speedier recovery, any more comfort during operation, anything different there?
It's more the ease of work. When my team is more relaxed, the patient will be more relaxed as well. You're a teacher, so when you sense some anxiety in the operating theater, the patient feels it, gets nervous, your surgery gets more difficult. So when my team is relaxed and working with the machine very, very easily, there is no tension in the OR. Everything goes much more at ease and everyone's happy. And that has to be our ultimate goal, that we lower the stress level in our OR and we transmit this to our patients.
Eric, I was going to wrap up and say thank you, but before I do, is there anything else that you wanted to mention?
Well, I don't think so. I would like to talk to the audience and say, like, why don't you try it? Just try it and feel for yourself, look for yourself, what is attractive to you, and how the system works. So that's my message to the audience.
That's brilliant. Thank you very much, Eric. It's been really interesting to hear more about the Sophi Phaco machine. Before this episode, I'd really only heard about it in the sustainability arena. So you've really opened up my eyes to new possibilities that this machine offers more than just a sustainable, reusable cassette. Thank you very much for joining me. Thank you to everyone listening as well. And I'll be back soon with another episode of Peer2Peer, the podcast.
Thank you, Ben, for having me.